10-second warning.
Well, I'll come on camera first.
Okay.
And then I'll...
まずこれがカメラに映って、で、合図を与えます。
Hi, Cap Community. Brelston here, kind of off to the side. We got our Resident Evil 6 stream. We're going to play a bit with the team here. We have Kobayashi-san, Sasaki-san, and off to the side, a little off the camera, Hiroyashi-san is watching and translating is Miguel.
Hello.
I'm ghosting over here on the side, but yeah, the team had a time to come by and play for us and talk about the game, and they're also able to take your questions. So we can actually, since we're going to be showing Jake's gameplay, I believe, correct?
Yep, we're showing Jake first.
Okay, so actually we'll go ahead and jump into the game here. And as usual, we have our...
Oh, we got some people that saw us on Spike TV as well.
Yes,
so
nice.
Thank you.
Yeah. So I'll cut to the game as soon as the... Do we want to watch the cutscene at the beginning? Or?
Yeah, it kind of...
Okay.
Yeah, as soon as... Yeah, hi. Let's go.
Go.
All right, so we'll just start off.
はい、T3 体験のジェイクをプレイしてますと。
Okay, what we're showing you is the playable demo for Jake that we have here at E3 to start. Don't worry, I'll get to the Jill and Claire question. Don't worry.
そうですね。はい。
Okay, this is actual gameplay right now. This is not a cutscene.
Here goes nothing!
ジェイクの得意なステのアクションなのでその辺をお見せしたいと思います。
Okay, Jake has a few extra moves that other characters in the game don't. He can use hand-to-hand combat techniques and do a couple combos on his enemies.
Nice.
It's
So a good way of conserving ammo.
Yeah. Even in the demos I've played, even with Chris and Jake, I still found myself running low on ammo, even though ostensibly you're loaded.
Yeah.
You really do run out of ammo quick.
That's why you really got to balance with the physical attacks.
Yeah.
このクリーチャーは映さなくなんですけど、このジェイク編にはもうずっと常に追っかけられる、追っかけてくる敵としてシェリーとジェイクをすでに付きまとう敵として今回登場します。
Okay, the creature Jake and Cherry are fighting there is called Ustanak. He's been following Jake and Cherry throughout their entire campaign. He won't give up.
A little bit of a kind of a nemesis homage almost.
Oh yeah, definitely.Up the herb.
Good. Yeah. You see there a lot of the sliding and 180 turns and a lot of cool mobility and a lot of combat options. It's still really powerful and it's really cool.
Yeah, a lot of the strategy is in the player's hands.
Yeah. I've had a great time playing this demo for the streams all week. Like it's so much fun.
$50 million.
Talk to my boss. Make it out of here alive.
はあの右手にアームを持ってて、まあ、ギミックでいろんなアームに切り替わるんですけど、今その掴むギミックなので掴まれないようにうまく逃げながら戦っていますと。
You want to pay special attention to Ustanak's arm?
Yes.
He can remove that arm and attach different weapons to it.
Oh, really?
So he's not always the same type of enemy.
Okay.
So right now he's got the claw arm, which he's trying to use to capture you.
I see.I did see that in the trailer, he has some kind of different thing on his back, it looked like.
Oh, that's a cage where he can put you in.
Nice.
So if your partner gets caught, you gotta go rescue him.
Yeah.Bumper to use some health there. Do not have regenerating health.
Yep. You can use health tablets and change weapons in real time.
Yep.
So no going to a sub menu. Yep.
Gotcha, son
of a bitch. Nice. Oh. Whoa.
That is a demo.
There we go.
はい、うまくいきましたんで、もうちょっとお見せします、別のところ。はい。
Okay. We can still show you a little more. We still have a little bit of time.
じゃあちょっとクリスのところ。はい。
Show a little bit of Chris within the time we can.
Yeah.
Don't worry, you'll be, the menus are customizable, so you can turn off the targeting and
クリスはあの中国のテロが起きているのを鎮圧しに BSA の、クリス隊が訪れています
。 OK、showing you a little bit of Chris's campaign right here. Again, he's leading a BSA team. They're in China right now trying to put down a bioterrorist attack.
And they're trying to get to this other hotel, like Ace of Spades, to there's some civilians trapped inside.
Right.
Chris, the noble soldier, trying to get to them and get them out.
Before they get devoured.
Before they turn into giant bugs. there you see one of them mutating.
これはドラゴンドンマンがついてた体験版はこれなんでしょうか。Okay. じゃあ答えなくてもいい。
About 10 seconds left here.
I thought you'd be all good.
I'll be able to cut that.
ここで切り替えできるので。
So that'll wrap it up for us as far as gameplay footage.
Done.
Okay.
はい、ということで、6のプレイは以上で終わりです。
Okay, that's all we're able to show you the gameplay, but let's get to some of your questions, okay?
Yes.
The one that keeps coming up
is... ちょっとディレクターからちょっと、まず今回初登場のジェイクというキャラクターをちょっと紹介をします。
Okay, first the director is going to tell us a little bit about Jake, since he's the new character in the game.
はい、ジェイクはですね、東ヨーロッパの方で、傭兵をしていた男なんですけども、今回シェリーの誘いを受けてですね、世界を救うために一緒に来てくれという、唐突な願いに乗るという形で、シェリーと一緒に、この物語に深く関わっていくことになります。先ほどちょっと見てもらった、ウッサナクという、大きな敵がいるんですけども、彼は捕獲者と言われていてですね、このジェイクを捕まえるために、ジェイクとシェリー2人を捕まえるためにですね、必要に、追っかけて、来続けれるということですね。
OK, so let's talk a little bit about Jake and Sherry. OK, Jake is a mercenary. He's working for a guerrilla army in Eastern Europe, as we saw. And then while he's there, Sherry encounters him, and Sherry says, I need you to help me. It turns out most of his mercenary team gets turned into creatures called Juavo.
Yes.
When they take injections of the C virus. So they're trying to escape. But someone has set the Ustanak creature after them, and the Ustanak creature is pursuing them throughout their campaign. He is one pain in the ass that he can't shake off.
I didn't know the bit about him changing arms. Like, I thought he was always a grapple arm. So it's
Kind of cool, he can change arms. Yeah, so the combat is always different.
Yeah. ジェイクはマーシャルアーツ格闘が得意なので、そこを今プレイした通り、アクションできますよというところは注目してください。
Alright, so what Jake can do is, as you saw in the demo there, he can fight using little good old fisticuffs, so hand-to-hand combat, so you can actually do those using the same controls you would use to fire your weapon.
Right.
So that's a good way to conserve ammo, and it adds some variety to the gameplay.
あとレオンとクリスとジェイクでそれぞれ UI が違うので、プレイ映像見た人は気づいたかもしれないですけど、そこはこだわりでそれぞれのキャラクターが持ってるガジェットを意識して、UI 作ってます。
And just as you saw the difference between Chris and Jake there, I'm not sure if anyone caught it, but the HUD for each character is different. So it adds a different feel to the gameplay mechanics, but you can turn all that off as well, so
あとクリスは今回 BSA の一個隊を率いているので、その人たちがどんどん戦いながら、やられたり消えたりするっていう、その集団のいなくなるホラーを描いているので、ジェイクの追っかけるホラーとは違うホラーを演じています。
So we've been talking about a lot of horror elements about Resident Evil 6 to the fans here at E3. One of the things we're trying to do, like you saidJake and Ustanak have that nemesis feel, so that's the horror setting we're trying to go for.
So an enemy that you cannot turn and face directly.
Exactly. Something you just got to outrun. And with Chris, it's more the horrors of being in war, losing your men, seeing them killed before your eyes, things like that. I mean, you're just being overwhelmed by creatures left and right.
Yeah.
So.
I do like that touch with Chris that even though it looks you can take cover, even though you have the mobility, you're still kind of, you know, have to watch your ammo, and also enemies can like get you in and out of cover. Like you're not safe. You still don't feel totally safe.
Right.
That's.
はい。で、まあ、あの今回 E3 ではレオンとクリスとジェイクそれぞれプレイできるんですけど、多分皆さんは早いところで言うとサンディエゴのコピコンでプレイできますので、もうちょっと待っててください。
So I'm sure everyone wants to play some of this Resident Evil 6. So we're pleased to say that if you make your way out to San Diego Comic-Con, nice. We will have the game playable there.
Cool. And it's probably the demo
For Leon and Jake. Yeah.
Okay, cool.
あとクレアとジェルは出る可能性はいかがでしょうか？
ああ、みんなクリスジルを出してほしいんですね。すごいいっぱいコメント多いですけど、まあ、果たしてどうかはお楽しみということで。はい。
Getting a lot of questions about Jill and Claire. I know everyone wants to see them in the game, but I mean, well, we're not finished making announcements for the game, so let's wait and see.
Okay. あとさっき面白かったのはウスタナクの衣装かっこいい、かわいいかかっこいいねってあったらおしゃれってなったんでありがとうございます。
We had a comment about Usnak saying likes all the little arm attachments.
Yeah.
So. Some people really like that.
このゲームのプレイ時間はどれくらいでしょうか？
だいたい一つのシナリオにつき、そうですね、まあ、7時間ぐらいは見れるんじゃないかなと思ってて、まあ、もちろんやり込みとかを考えると、もうちょっと相当な、時間用意できてると思います。
何時間？
7時間ぐらい。1人のキャラで7時間ぐらい。
Okay. Just playing with about one character is about, I don't know, 7 to 8 hours, so okay. Times three. But I mean, that's if you do a straight run through. If you do everything and take your time exploring, it'll be much longer than that.
ちなみにあの1シナリオで2人の主人公がいるので、それぞれの主人公だけでしか見れない部分とかもあるので、あのぜひあの1つのシナリオで、そうですね、レオン編だったらレオンとヘレナ2人とも楽しんでほしいですね。
And you can play co-op, of course. And you, so, for example, in Leon's campaign, you can play as Leon or Helena. If you play as Leon, there are things you can do and see in his campaign that you can't when you use Helena, and vice versa. Right. So there is a reason to go back and play as both.
Yeah, I saw in the Chris demo, Piers and Chris get separated, and Piers has to like cover Chris as he's jumping from rooftop to rooftop.
今回あの E3 でクロスオーバーを発表したんですけど、まあ、当然レオンとクリスも関わりますし、クリスとジェイク、まあ、ジェイクとレオンも関わるんですけど、あの重なるからといってそれぞれのストーリーがあの全て一緒ではないので、ちゃんとレオン、クリス、ジェイクってそれぞれをちゃんとクリアまで遊んでもらうと、より一層その6のスケール感だったりとか6の謎が分かると思うので、ぜひ3人のプレイヤーをクリアしてほしいなと思います。
Again, something we're promoting here at E3 is the crossover feature of the game. So while you're playing through Leon and Helena's story, for example, you'll interact with Chris and Piers or Jake and Sherry, and the stories will intersect at those points.
Yes.
But Leon's campaign is something that stands unto itself. It's a complete story, start, finish, with an ending. But if you then go and play the other two campaigns, you'll get a more rounded story, a more in-depth look at the RE6
world.
See how
they connect to each other.
Exactly.
Seen some questions, skill points. People have seen that showing up in the streams. If there's anything to talk about skill points just yet.
あのスキルポイントについて何か教えていただけないでしょうか。
はい。今回ちょっと用意しているスキルポイントシステムとかスキルシステムはですね、それぞれのプレイヤーのまあ、プレイスタイルとか、それからシナリオ内の状況に合わせて自分の好きなスキルをあの組み合わせて自分だけのキャラクターというか、スキルキャラクターを作ることができるというシステムです。
Okay, so you collect these skill points and you can use them to purchase, obviously, skills. It's a little different from the weapons upgrade system we had before, so you can purchase different skills and attach them to your character, and you can make a unique character based on those skills. So the way you want to play the game, maybe you're not good at certain aspects, so you need more strength or better moves in a certain area, you can add those skills to your character and make them better.
攻撃が得意、アクションが得意な人は攻撃に特化したキャラクターも作れるし、まあ、ちょっと苦手かなという人もあのディフェンスが強いとか、AI の仲間が、よく助けてくれるようになるとか、まあ、いろんな、初心者から上級者まで楽しめるスキルいっぱい用意してますので楽しみにしてください。
Yeah, so you can make it, you can customize the game in that way. For example, if you just want to just blast through enemies, you can add all the skills that increase your firepower and make you more powerful shooter. If you're not so good at the game, you can make it so your partner will always come to your rescue and give you the health pickup you need.
Okay.
So, and you can also make yourself more durable as well, able to withstand attacks better. So depending how you want to play the game, what your strengths and weaknesses are, you can use the skills to adjust that.
I've seen a lot of people asking about any updates on the PC version, or if there might be a demo for PC as there is with consoles.
パソコンの、PC 版はの予定はあるでしょうか。あと PC 版の用の体験版は用意されてるでしょうか。
あ、はい。PC 版はまあ発売することは決定してるんですけど、ちょっといつ発売するとか、まあ、どういう内容とかっていうのはちょっとまだ言えないので、本当にちょっと。もうちょっと本当にコンシューマーが落ち着いたらまた情報をしっかり出していきたいと思います。
I know everyone wants a release for the PC version. Fortunately, there will be a PC version. We just haven't announced when it's coming out. I mean, we're still trying to finish working on the game before we can even think about that. But there will be a PC version, and there'll be special content for that. But we haven't finalized any of the details yet.
See some questions about if there's any kind of puzzles to solve during the gameplay.
Oh, okay.
Or if it's more.
で、ゲーム中にはなんかパズルとかは用意されてるでしょうか。
はい、もちろんありますよ。はい、まあ、手強い謎もあったりとかしますんで、そこら辺は、1とか2とか3とかあたりの、まあ、探索的な要素の一つにもなりますね。
Oh yeah, there are definitely puzzles in this game, and especially there's some tricky ones in there as well. So if you really like Resident Evil 1, 2, and 3, some of the puzzles there, especially the things where you have to explore a bit before you can solve the puzzles,
right.
We've got those in RE6.
It's like something for everyone kind of game, but it's a little bit of everything. Obviously people asking, very curious about Mercenaries mode, which I know we're not showing, but
sure.
We could discuss that at all.
ちょっとマーセナリーズについて何か情報を教えていただけないでしょうか。
多分もちろんありますよ。ちょっと力入れて作ってるんで、これ楽しみにしてもらっていいんじゃないかなと。
あとキャプテベイって発表したことも言っていいですか。キャプテベイ。いや、マジネージは最初からプレイできる。Okay. Yeah. The director, we put a lot of work into Mercenaries. We're making it a really robust feature of the game. And as we announced at Captivate, it will be playable from the beginning. So you don't have to finish the game once before you can play Mercenaries. You can play it right from the start. So, Ada のことも書いてある。なんか、Ada の、なんか、Ada のふりをしてるキャラクターもいるんじゃないでしょうか。
people are asking about Helena Harper, I guess, more a bit of background or a bit about the character.
Oh, okay. ちょっと Helena Harper は新キャラなんですけど、Helena Harper っていうのは新キャラクターなんですけど、彼女についてその背景とかストーリーちょっと教えていただけないでしょうか。
そうですね。まあ、合衆国のエージェントの一人なんですけども、まあ、ちょっと勝ち気なというか、感情の起伏が激しい女性なんですけどね。まあ、レオンはいつも毎シリーズごとに女性に振り回されるっていうキャラクターでもあるんですけど、まあ、ヘレナも十二分にレオンを振り回すことになると思います。まあ、ちょっと彼女はですね、まあ、ちょっと今回のトレーラーとかでね、少しちょっとこの、デボラという女性というか、なんて言ったらいいかな。まあ、実はトレーラーの中に出てくるデボラという女性は彼女の妹です、でして、でその彼女の妹が、まあ、何らかの、まあ、やばい状況になっていると。で彼女はその中で、この事件に、好まざると関与してしまうことになるんですけども、まあ、そこら辺はもうぜひちょっとシナリオを、やってみて、なぜ彼女がこういうことになってしまったのかというのを分かってほしいなと思います。
Okay, just giving you a little background on Helena Harper, the new character, female character in the game. She is the special agent, not the same type as Leon, but she is a special agent. And Leon has kind of a history of being played with by women, toyed around with, you know.
Led down a wrong path.
Yeah, he's pretty easy to manipulate. So now, who is Helena? Is she manipulating Leon into working for her, or is she just using him? We've seen in the trailer that she has a sister named Deborah, and something happens to Deborah that forces Helena into a situation where she has to act against her will on behalf of her sister. So, yeah, we come clear once you play the game. You can get a little tease of it in the trailer if you check that out.
I see a lot of people asking, last time Ada Wong appeared, we got RE4 had the nice separate ways thing, so people are asking, since Ada's in this, if there's more to Ada than we've seen, if she ends up, you know, being in the game at all or anything like that.
Nanka Ada ga dete kisou na fuinki nan desu kedo, sono
kyaru.
Ah, hai. Ne, sono RE4 no toki wa Ada ga deteru kara, sono tokubetsu na modo, Ada seiyou no modo ga atta n desu kedo, konka Ada ga deteru kara tokubetsu modo ga yoi saretete deshou ka?
はい、まあ、エイダ皆さんお好きなんで、その期待に応えればいいなと思って、まあ、どうなるか今後お楽しみください。
Okay, well, everyone wants to know about Ada and what that means for the game. That's just something you're gonna have to wait for right now. Not ready to talk about that, just being...
I agree, I just want to make sure I got the question.
Yeah, sure, no problem. I'm glad people are interested in Ada and what that means.
And, a lot of people also asking, the scale of this is so high. The scale is so high, like, obviously this wouldn't be the last Resident Evil, but it almost seems this is a challenge conceptually with the escalation so high, it conceivably could look like the end of at least some character's stories. So I wonder if it was, you know, a challenge of, you know, painting yourself in a corner when a game gets so big, if the stakes are so high, like how do you keep pushing it?
まあ、今回のタイトルのスケールが大きいので、なんかまずは苦労したんじゃないですか。で、これからの展開に関しては、なんか展開があるんでしょうか。
まあ、とりあえず今はまずこの6の世界を存分に楽しんでほしいなと思ってます。本当に、すごいスケール感とボリューム感、クオリティで、作ることができたなと思ってますし、まあ、チームも今全力で、完成に向けて頑張ってますんで、まずは6、楽しみに待っていてくださいと。
Okay, first I think you need to focus on 6.
Right, of course.
Yeah, we put a lot of work into the content of this game, the scale is huge for this game. That doesn't mean it's going to close off any possibilities in the future, but for right now, I think once you see 6, you'll be satisfied with what we've done with it.
はい、で、まあ、ボリュームはあるんですけど、まだ皆さんにお伝えしているのはほんの一部だと思います。レオンとクリスとジェイクのことですら一部ですし、もっとそのヘレナとかピアースとかシェリーとかも全然まだ伝えてないことがたくさんあります。当然エイダのことに対してもたくさん伝えられてないことがいっぱいあります。
And, I know everyone's got questions about what's in the game, what's not in the game, but what we've revealed so far is really only the tip of the iceberg. We've only talked even just a little bit about Jake, Chris and Leon right now. We still haven't really got into Helena, Sherry and Piers and what they can do and what else is in the game. There's so much more than just what we've been talking about.
Yeah. July, I believe, for Xbox.
They
Dragon's Dogma.
What are you right?
はい、最後の方で、で、体験版は7月。
はい、ドラゴンズドグマの、ソフトを買ってもらうと、7月3日に360の体験版がありますし、PS3 は9月の4日に体験版配信しますので、いち早く遊びたい人はそれを遊んでみてください。
So yeah, if you bought Dragon's Dogma, you'll be able to play the demo. July 3rd on Xbox 360, so I encourage you to get that. If you're PlayStation, you'll have to wait a little longer. That'll be available in September.
And some people asking will it eventually come? People are wondering if it'll eventually come to just freely available demo down the line.
So no, Dragon's Dogma, call なくてもいつか体験版プレイできる。ようになるでしょうか、360で。
まあ、コミコンで遊んでもらうことは全然できるんで、ショーとかには出しますし、まあ、一番早く本当に遊びたいなら申し訳ないですけど、ドラゴンドグマ買ってもらうのが一番いいと思います。
Well, we'll be having it on around at Comic-Con and different shows and events, so if you come out to them, you'll be able to play it there. For now, you need to get Dragon's Dogma if you want to play that demo.
Yeah. I got time for one more question.
Okay.
Down the list here.
Yeah, it just moves so fast.
Yeah. Anything we can actually answer.
You got to balance it. You don't want to spoil things. You don't want to reveal everything all at once. Mm-hmm. So, a lot of people asking if are there any other online game modes. Obviously, you know, Mercenaries is on people's minds, but is there anything else to look forward to?
Mercenaries 以外のまあオンラインモードとか配信コンテンツは用意されているでしょうか。
そうですね。まだまだ言えないんですけど、いろんな、オンラインで遊べるモードも用意してますので、発売までいろんな情報を出すので情報をチェックしてください。
So, we haven't revealed a lot of this yet, but yes, there will be more than just mercenaries. We got a lot of modes and stuff and.
Awesome.
Extra content that's going to become available. Cool. We'll be making more announcements as we get closer to the release date for that. But yes, there's more than just Mercenaries in the game.
Yeah, there's still a lot of big shows throughout the year. We have Gamescom, we have TGS.
Yeah.
A lot of big shows.
Yeah, the game doesn't come out until October 2nd, which is only 4 months away, but still. We got a lot of time to make announcements.
All right, so we're going to wrap it up here. I just want to thank you guys for coming on. And,
okay. 今日時間いただいてありがとうございました。 Yes. Okay, I'll just say final word.
Sure, go for it.
はい、本当に今回ちょっとクロスオーバーというのを軸に楽しんでもらおうかなと思ってて、でもちろん他のシナリオ同士プレイヤーキャラクターが最大4人で同時に、ゲームプレイできるっていうのもあるんですけど、一つのシナリオの、では、分からない、その裏側で起こっていた物語であるとか、もっともっと深い事件の真相であるとかっていうのはいろんなシナリオを遊ぶことによって分かるというような、構造になっているので、全シナリオをぜひ楽しんでほしいなと思います。
Okay, again we have three characters, three main protagonists, three stories, three separate campaigns. You can play co-op in all of them, but as you play them, you're going to encounter other characters in the crossover, so you can have up to four players online playing sections of the story together. I encourage you to play all the characters' campaigns because that will give you a fuller version of the story. It will make your experience that much richer when playing Resident Evil 6, so please check out everything in the game.
はい、E3 でいろいろ発表できて大変嬉しく思ってます。トレーラーだったりとか、レオン、クリス、ジェイクのそれぞれのプレイゾーンも出してると思いますので、そちらを見て多分北米の皆さん多分コミコンで僕も行きますし、実際プレイしてもらったら嬉しいなと思いますので、これからもよろしくお願いします。
Alright, yeah, we've made a lot of announcements here at E3. We've shown off a little bit of Leon, a little bit of Jake. I hope that gives you a taste of what's to come. Next time we get to make some more announcements, we'll be at Comic-Con. We'll have more information for you. And and just on behalf of myself, just like to say thanks to everyone for writing in and asking questions. I'm sorry we can't answer them all. I wish we did have the time. But I'm glad there's all these Resident Evil fans out there that want to take the time to watch us and listen to us talk.
And the line yesterday to get into RE6 was like all the way around the booth, so it's looking good.
Yep.
Thanks everyone for watching. Thanks for coming on. And we'll be back at 11 with DMC. We'll be right back.
Bye. Thank you.